हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रीति तिक्कस, लेक्चरर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ए शिफ्ट ऑफ प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ फिफ्थ चैप्टर इज प्रोसीजर ऑफ डिस्प्ले ऑफ नियॉन ट्यूब एंड नियॉन ट्यूब फॉर एडवर्टाइजिंग. सो फर्स्ट, व्हाट आर द प्रोसीजर टू डिस्प्ले द नियॉन ट्यूब फॉर एडवर्टाइजिंग. सो the procedure is making luminous tube display is as follows. The sketch is increased to actual size and pronounced upon asbestos. Straight length of glass tubing is desired diameter are then heated and blow to the shape of sketch. Electrodes are then sealed in at each end of the glass tube. Then the air is pumped out the neon gas pump in the tube seal. So this is the diagram for the of neon tube. So after aging process, which further purified the gas, this part is ready to attach to the metal framework or box and lighted. In luminous gas sign, it is necessary to use the high tension current to send it through a sufficient length of the glass tube. In this country, the current average about 800 volt, but it is low ampere and not dangerous to life. So in this diagram, it has a neon transformer, step up transformer, then high voltage which is given to the neon tube. In that neon tube, electrodes, high tension cable connector, electrodes, these are used. And here this is the transformer, so low voltage to high voltage it is transfer. Now when the neon gas is contained in the transparent glass and agitated with electricity, it glow with an orange red color. Various other glasses alone and in combination is used to secure the other colors. For the blue light, mercury is introduced into the tube, which vaporize. For the green light, contents of the tube are same as for the blue light, and as amber color glass is used instead of the transparent glass. When a sign is completed to the ordinary 110 volt current is connected with the sign, from there it goes through a step up transformer and then through the glass tube. As a rule, all the high tension wiring is properly insulated and contained within the sign. About 50 feet of the glass tubing can be operated from the transformer, but usually about 5 foot length of the glass tube are used for the convenience in handling, installing and repairing. Wire jumping cover over connected the 5 foot length to get the maximum amount of tubing operating on each transformer. The amount of tubing which can be operated from the transformer depends on the diameters of tube and the gaseous content of the tube which regulated the color. In operation, the glass tubing content, the glass is part of the electrical circuit and it is action of the electric current on the gas in the tube which cause the light. The neon light is a cold light as there is no filament in the tube to becomes heated. Accordingly, since the energy is not wasted through the generations of the heat, the current consumption is low. So these are the procedure for the neon tube, display of neon tube. The next is terminology used in street lighting. So what are the terminology is used? So first one is the visual performance, next is visual comfort, then next terminology is contrast, then glare, then field of vision, then uniformity ratio, and last is sharpness of the vision. So we will discuss one by one. First one is visual performance. So visual performance means the revealing power. Revealing power is the ability to perceive obstructions on the road by the statistic distribution of the occurrence of reflection caused by the pedestrian clothing at the darkness location on the road. Visual performance is the ability of the driver for performing a visual task and statistically given by his relieving power. Then visual comfort. This is the concern with the longitudinal uniformity of luminance. So it is the ratio of minimum luminance divided by maximum luminance as the measured along medial of the traffic lane in the direction of the traffic flow. Then contrast. It is the subjective assessment of the difference in the appearance of two parts of field of view seen simultaneously or successively. Then contrast sensitivity. It is measured by the adjacent illumination level of the task in such a way that object is just perceptible and is defined as a background luminance divided by the luminance threshold. So it is the reciprocal of contrast. Contrast sensitivity is called as a contrast threshold. The next terminology is glare. The condition of the vision in which there is the discomfort or reduction in ability to see the significant object, that is loss of detail due to an unsuitable distributions of the luminous or due to the extreme contrast space wise or time wise. Glare may cause annoyance, interference, loss of vision and fatigue. Glare may be direct or reflected, may come from the light source directly, or it may be reflected brightness from the polished surface such as nickel chromium or platinum plate surface or high calendared paper. Then field of vision. The angular extents of the space, angular extent of space which come in view of eyes when adopted to see the straight in defined weather condition. Vision may be monocular or binocular. Next is uniformity ratio. Uniformity ratio is of illumination on the given plane is measured variations of the illuminance over the plane expressed as either E minimum by E maximum or overall uniformity. E minimum upon E. That means illumination minimum divided by illumination maximum. Then is visual sharpness of vision. The visual sharpness of vision is the capacity of the eyes for viewing the distinctly the object which are very close together. So these are the terminologies of the street lighting. Then what are the comparison between street lighting and indoor lighting? The natural nature of road or street lighting is altogether different than the indoor lighting. This is due to number one, there are the no wall and ceiling which can reflect on diffuse light so long, and the hard show cannot be avoided. Indoor illumination level is much more than the street lighting as the area to be illuminated is very vast. Road behaves as a diffuse surface when an angle of incidence is small, and as reflecting surface when the diffusion principle is perception of object and the vehicle driver makes use of the spectacular reflection that is above the property is served to both. The next comparison is driver encountered with high angle of incidence whereas pedestrians perceive at lower angle of incidence. Thank you.